Today we study about an experiment called as tonometer 1. Okay, right. So first we'll see the about the apparatus. Okay, this is called as a tonometer box. So we can see on a tonometer box, this is a wire which is fixed at one end. Okay, right. It is resting on these two bridges. Okay, so these are the two bridges on which it is resting. Okay, wire it passes over a pulley. And from a pulley, we are attached a load which is of a 2 kg weight. Okay, which is of a 2 kg weight. So we can see as the wire is resting on these two bridges. Okay, as we can see from a diagram which is shown over here. Okay, then by some means, suppose if we had set this wire into vibration. Okay, that is as we know, these are the tuning forks. When we vibrate, set them into vibration, they vibrate at a given frequency. Okay, say in this case, yapalika it is of 112 Hz. So when I set this into vibration, it is vibrating at a frequency of what? 112 Hz. Okay, so if I place it on a sonometer box, this wire of what? It will start vibrating at a frequency of what? A tuning fork. That is, it is under a influence of this external periodic force, so that wire will also start vibrating at a frequency of what? 512 Hz. Okay, so in that case, jo nodes form hota hai, as we can see, the wire is resting on these two bridges. The nodes will be forming at what? These two bridges, and the antinode kaha pe form hoga? In between these two bridges, right? So basically, what we do is we change the distance between the two bridges. As the distance between the two bridges changes, the natural frequency at which the wire is vibrating, it will change. As we have seen, what n is, or it is the inversely proportional to what? Length. So as we change the length, the natural frequency at which the wire is vibrating, okay, it changes. So at a particular length between the two bridges, the natural frequency at which the wire is vibrating will become same as the frequency of a external periodic force, that is that of a tuning fork. Okay, so at that case, the wire starts what? Vibrating at a maximum amplitude. Okay, and that length is called as what? Vibrating length. That length is called as a vibrating length. So over here, we'll be finding a vibrating length by a paper rider method. That is, we take a paper rider and place in between these two bridges. Almost center pe rakhte. Why? Because over there antinode has been formed. Okay, so that we'll be getting a better results. Okay, so coming to observation table. So in this case, we are keeping a tension constant of what? 2 kg weight. We would be taking a frequencies, tuning fork of what? Different frequencies. That is, we are performing the experiment by what? Taking one tuning fork at a time. That is, pilot will be performing experiment with a tuning fork of 112 Hz, then 480 Hz, and order the frequency will be taking the tuning forks of what? Tuning fork of frequencies in a decreasing order for a reason. Okay, right. So let us see how to take a reading for what? Say first tuning fork, that is 512 Hz. Okay, right. So set this tuning fork into vibration. Okay, place it over a sonometer box. Okay, so on doing so, the wire, this wire, okay, it will start vibrating. Okay, this is under the influence of an external periodic force, that is a tuning fork. Okay, that is, it will be vibrating at a frequency of what? 512. Okay, but the natural frequency of what wire is, what is okay, it depends upon the length between these two bridges. Okay, so in this particular experiment, what we'll be doing is we are changing the distance, yeah, length of a wire between these two bridges. On doing so, the natural frequency at which the wire is vibrating, it will change. And at a particular length between these two bridges, kya hoga? Natural frequency will become same as the frequency of what? External periodic force, where it will be under it will be resonating. Okay. So first, keep the distance between our two bridges what? Minimum. Okay, that is, ek bridge se keep it at a distance. Again, we can take any distance. I kept it at what? 50 centimeter. okay, I will be moving another bridge. Say initially I kept it at what 61 centimeter. So while taking a reading, आपको क्या करना है, we have to take a distance between these two bridges. That is one I kept it at 50 centimeter. Okay, तो length क्या रहेगा in this case? It will be 61 minus 50 and so on. Okay, right? So take a tuning fork about 512 hertz. Set into vibration. Okay, right? Slowly increase the distance between the two bridges through a very small distance. Okay. Also change the position. See to that paper adder is almost in the middle of the two bridges. Increase the length between the two bridges. ओके, थोड़ा से 1.1-1.2 सेंटीमीटर से इंक्रीज करना है. वी कैन सी एट दिस पर्टिकुलर इट इज वाइब्रेटिंग वायलेंटली. ओके, इसका मतलब क्या, नेचुरल फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ वायर इज. ओके, लेट अस इंक्रीज वायर स्मॉल डिस्टेंस. Okay, we can say it is fluttering violently. Okay, so at a particular length between the two bridges, what we have seen over here, paper rider after fluttering it has fall down. Okay, right? Why? Because the wire is vibrating at a maximum amplitude, which will happen at a resonating length. Okay, that at a particular length, the natural frequency of a wire will be same as the frequency, external frequency of what, forced vibration. That is, in this case, forced vibration, it is a tuning fork. Okay, so we how would be writing a reading. Okay, so 512 hertz ka tuning fork liya hai. Okay, at which we are getting a vibrating length. Iska matlab kya, wire is vibrating at a length of what, at a frequency of 512 hertz. Okay, iska what is the vibrating length in that case. Okay, we have to take a distance between what, these two bridges. Okay, we can see we have kept one bridge at what, 50 centimeter. Another bridge is at how much? It is 62.4 centimeter. That is, difference between them is how much? It is 12.4 centimeter, right? For the same tuning fork, kya karo students? For चेक वेदर यू आर गेटिंग सेम वाइब्रेटिंग लेंथ या क्लोज. ये वाइब्रेटिंग लेंथ क्या रहेगा, इट विल बी रिमेनिंग ऑलमोस्ट कॉन्स्टेंट. वाई बिकॉज इफ यू आर परफॉर्मिंग एक्सपेरिमेंट वॉट केयरफुली, इट विल बी रिमेनिंग कॉन्स्टेंट थ्रू आउट. ओके, टेक थ्री सेट ऑफ रीडिंग. ओके, आई से इट विल बी रिमेनिंग क्लोज या ऑलमोस्ट सेम, दैट इज 12.4 सेंटीमीटर, विच वी कैन राइट वॉट मीन एल. ओके, फाइंड वैल्यू ऑफ वॉट एन एल. ओके, find value of what, NL, that is in this case character, it will be 512 into 12.4 centimeter, right? This value what, it remains constant. Okay, this value what, it remains constant. Okay, if we see the formula for fundamental frequency of a vibrating string, this is a formula. Okay, N is equal to 1 upon 2 by L into what, square root of T by M, right? So in this case, small m is what, linear density of wire, which is constant. Okay, tension is remaining constant. So n is what, is n is inversely proportional to what, 2l. Yeah, if I take a product of what, nl, okay, it will be at remaining constant. So as value of what n changes, value of what l would be what changing, but overall what would be happening, product of what n into l will be at remaining constant. So that is nothing but what called as what, first law of what, sonometer. Okay, which we have be what proving through a experiment. Okay, so we have found a vibrating length for what, 512 hertz. Now we'll be taking a tuning fork of what, 480 hertz, and check what is the vibrating length in case of what, 480 hertz. Again, we can start from a same length. See to it that we are placing a paper rider almost in between the two bridges. Okay. Increase the distance between two bridges to a very small distance. Okay. Right. We have seen what the paper adder has for when we have distance between two bridges is this much. How much it is? It is 62.6. So 62.6 minus 50 will be how much? It will be 12.6. Okay. So take a product of what? 480 into 12.6. Find kado how much it is. Okay. The value of what? N into L what? It should remain constant, almost constant. Okay. Similarly, you can do it for the tuning fork of what? Different frequencies. Okay. If the value of what? NL is remaining constant. Okay. We can say what? First law of what? Sonometer is been verified. Okay. So, this is a result. Okay. As we observe the value of what? NL is remaining constant within the experimental errors. Okay. This verifies NL is what is constant. N is inversely proportional to L. Right. Thank you.